First of all, I would like to thank the organizers of this seminar for the interest they gave to the geology of Morocco. The objective of this presentation is to share the results of our publication entitled Barremian Intracontinental Rifts and Archean Atlantic Transgression in the Northern Boundary of the Central High Atlas. The Atlas chain is one of the major features of the Western Cities domain. It extends for about 205 kilometers from the Atlantic coast of Morocco to the Mediterranean coast of Tunisia. The Moroccan Atlas system is one segment of the Atlas Mountains. Is divided into an east west east north northeast west southwest branch, the High Atlas, and a northeast southwest branch, the Middle Atlas. Both mountain range diverge towards the east from an intersection area, near Bni Mellal locality. Having the demi-sur bassin called the Haute Melouia bassin, the easternmost part of the Atlas in Morocco territory shows a purely east-west direction. The objective of this study is firstly to precise the paleogeography of the Absentia by evaluating its possible extension towards the east and or the north. It is necessary to state that no information is possible towards the south of or the southwest in the Atlas Belt, where the wall post-Jurassic series has been eroded or it was never deposited. The second objective is to establish whether there was structural sedimentary framework associated with this transgressive episode. We will analyze the nature and distribution of the Barremian and Absentian continental and marine deposits. Then we will propose a dynamic construction of the structural framework that preceded and accompanied the Absentian transgression. The Central High Atlas comprises the most representative Mesozoic outcrops of Mesozoic material of the Moroccan sector of the chain. It extends from the Tizintishka, from the Tizintishka pass to the Middle Errachidia transversal. The Central High Atlas is constituted by Mesozoic marine and terrigenous series, totaling more than 500 meters of sand rift deposits. The stratigraphic column of the basophylline extends from Triassic to Cretaceous time. Furthermore, deposits of Cenozoic age appear in scattered outcrops in different parts of the chain. The structuring of the Central High Atlas is characterized by suction of weight syncline, whose core are occupied by Dogger or Cretaceous continental deposits and the magmatic effusive. These syncline are separated by narrow intercalated called ridge, defined by the Liasic series and quarried by Triassic shale and volcanic materials. Structures show two main trends, east-west and north-east-west. In general, pluricilometric thrusts are common at the northern and southern borders of the chain and scarcer in its inner parts. The study area is located at the the junction of the between the Middle Atlas and the Central High Atlas, and the Upper Meruya to Yazd. It is dominated by deposits ranging from Triassic to Quaternary. It is organized in Sanklin, the Nawor Sanklin, Tizinisli Sanklin, Arbala Sanklin, and Tiza Sanklin, et Tifert Sanklin. We subdivided this study area into three blocks. The southern block is limited by the Arbala Afurar fault zone. The southern block is located between the Arbala Afurar fault zone and the Arbala Nawor fault. The central block is located between the Arbala Nawor fault and the North El Qsiba fault. The northern block is located on the north of the North El Qsiba faults. Three faults divided this study area on three blocks. The study area lithostratigraphy is characterized by the Belwidan group dated to Bajusian. Tilguit formation is dated to Batonian. The Jurassic Cretaceous red bed is the group is divided in three formations. The Ktiwa formation is a formation characterized by the sandstone and the siltstone in clays. The Euryden formation dated to Upper Jurassic to Valanginian is characterized by the siltstone with the dolomites. The Jbel Sidal formation dated to Barremian is characterized by siltstone with conglomerates. Two magmatic levels called in the literature B1 with B2 characterize this group, this Jurassic Cretaceous bed. The Aptian formation called Eitefels is characterized by limestone with the ammonite 4BC zone. Our field data concerning the Barremian sedimentary record in the southern block. The southern block in the Nawor Sanklin is characterized by three compartments. The southern compartment is characterized by the formation of Jebel Sidal veritic. In the Nawor central block, the formation of Jebel Sidal have a 550 thick meter. In the Arbala, the Jebel Sidal formation is very thick, about 100 meter. The central block, the Jebel Sidal formation is characterized by siltstone with the sandstone. Here, his thickness is reduced here about 50 meters. In the northern block, the Jebel Sidal formation is reduced in thickness, is characterized by conglomerates, is started by conglomerates. Deposit on unconformity here. The Aptian sedimentary records in the southern block. In the southern block, exclusively marine, is characterized by the Eitefels formation in the Arbala West and Arbala East and Nawor South, show green and white colored marls followed by alternating marls and limestone characterized by thinning upwards bits. The limestone are mainly bioclastic grindstone deposits. The marls of the lower middle member have provided some ostracots, gastropods and benthic foraminifera including Schuvatella dissipiens. To the years of Arbala, in the sandstone bits previously attributed to Jurassic Gitiwa formation in the literature, we discovered an Aptian fossiliferous shallow water limestone series, the latter about 20 meters thick, can be observed in the footwall of Aroverse Fall. It shows three superimposed members. They consist mainly of calcareous layers with gastropods and bivalves alternating with marly limestone and beige marls. Benthic foraminifera, particularly Schuvatella dissipiens, Schlumbergi, have been found.
You got 10 minutes.
Yes, in the central zone, the Tisza Sanclin, the south of the Tisza Sanclin, the tertiary tracing of Triassic basalt and the Jurassic carbonate caused the overturning of the entire Cretaceous series. The thickness of the Barremian Aptian formation is reduced. In the Tiffert Sanclin, the northern block, the Eitefeld formation dated Aptian is characterized by gypsum and red marls. In the Moulay-Aqoub locality, the Aptian formation is characterized by dolomite with marls. In the Boutaqa, the Aptian formation is characterized by marmorized calcareous. Our field data in the Nawur blocks can be demonstrate clearly that several blocks of contracting stratigraphic composition are separated by different faults. One of them is clearly pre-Aptian, the Arbala Nawur fault. The second is a small post-Aptian offset. The subsidence is particularly important in the Bathonian with the Barremian. The paleogeographic reconstruction of the Barremian show that in the northern zone, the Tisza and Tiffert blocks, the Jebel Sidal formation is characterized by thin series, one to several tens of meters, often starting succession. The zone extends northward over a minimum of 80 kilometers with similar facies. The development of a thicker calcarenitic series to the north near the North Iltiba fault could indicate some activity of this fault during the Barremian time. This northern zone was a stable high block where the detrital materials come from both neighboring Mesozoic and Paleozoic outcrops. In the southern zone, Aqbala Nawur blocks, the Jebel Sidal formation is characterized by a silty clay series, several 100 meters thick, several thick meters of thickness. In the Nawur block, 2,000 meters to the west of Arbala. This sedimentary accumulation zone indicates a down-thrown block related to the Arbala Nawur fault, normal fault, which limits it to the north. Normal sedimentary faults, such as those observed west of Arbala, close to the Arbala Nawur faults. The paleogeographic reconstruction of the Aptian shows that an Aptian gulf developed on a structural trough. A marine sedimentation present from west to east, the Aptian deposits are still relatively uniform in thickness and shallow marine facies along the Barremian gravel axis, and no facies variation indicating the limit of the Atlantic Gulf should be found eastwards. In the In the central blocks, the Aptian formation shows two marine series separated by an continental levels. North of the North Elqsiba Fault, the Aptian formation shows the lagunal facies, the gypsum and the dolomites. To the north, the Aptian formation is characterized by marmorized limestone, and no marine facies have observed. In the Morocco, we have constructed and maps of the paleogeographic on the Aptian and the Barremian. The similar zone in the Morocco, the Golman area, and the North Atlantic faults. In the Africa, the Arbala, the Barremian Aptian structural sedimentary framework described in the Atlas system can be a good example for understand the various Neocretaceous transgression that occurred in a similar context in the pre-Cratonic domain. First, we must mention the Lower Cretaceous rifts of the Benue that appeared in the southern area of the West African Craton, associated with the opening of the South Atlantic Ocean. The major recorded discontinuity dates from the Aptian, while most of the African gradients, such as that of the Benue, have remained the seat of a continental sedimentation. Some, such as those of the Côte d'Ivoire and Ghana, recorded an Aptian marine transgression from the young South Atlantic. In Europe, the analogies can be envisaged with early Cretaceous Iberian Basin, associated with the Mesozoic Iberian Rift System, which were reached by the first Neocretaceous transgression. Our research in the transition zone between the Central High Atlas and the Middle Atlas provide a new data of different kinds. The contribution to the Lower Cretaceous stratigraphy and paleogeography of Morocco, the distinction between the Jurassic and Cretaceous continental rifts reveals that the Barremian sedimentation has a unsuspected importance in the studied area. This continental sedimentation, which occurs on a previously structured and eroded Jurassic substratum, the structural control during the Barremian and Aptian sedimentation, field data allows us to establish that there was a structural control of the Barremian Aptian sedimentation by normal faulting. The Barremian sedimentation was concentrated in an east-west oriented gravel. And finally, the paleogeographic evolution from the Barremian Rift to the Barremian Aptian Gulf. And thank you for your attention.
So you have a lot of descriptions of stratigraphic and sedimentologic observations. Did you do also some work on the structures, on the faults, and what type of faults and fault movement you can observe?
Yes, the movement is a strict slope with extension or transtension. A sinistral strict slope.
Okay.
Yes.
Mo, you can ask your question.
Yeah, thanks, Gwen. Thanks, Mustafa, for the presentation. I was wondering, so like you showed the like similarities between what you've seen actually in this part of the Atlas with other like extensional basins that occurred at the same time in other parts of Africa. So I was wondering actually if you think that there is a link between those different basins, and if not, what do you think actually is driving that extension or transtension in this part of the High Atlas, because it comes actually quite late actually in Barremian Aptian. So I was wondering if you have any idea about what would be driving that extensional tectonics at that time in Cretaceous.
These events, extensional events, is related to the opening of the Atlantic and the magmatism, the Bathonian from Lower Cretaceous.
Okay. Is it just like a follow-up question if I still have time? Yeah, is it do you think that there is like, because like you have also like a little bit, I'm not sure actually like from the tectonic point of view, but from like stratigraphic point of view, you have similar sediments actually also on the western part of the High Atlas. So like if you look actually like close to the Atlantic coast, you can see some Barremian and to Upsian Albian sediments actually that have been related to like some marine incursion coming from the Atlantic. So like, do you think that like the whole system extended from the western part of the Atlantic and then went actually like that far east? Or do you think actually it's like different evolution, but like it just like they show different stratigraphy?
To the west in the Atlantic Atlas, the Upsian formation is very thick in thickness, and in the central Atlas, the thickness are reduced from the west to east. In the intersection zone between the High Atlas and the Middle Atlas, the transgression Atlantic is limited by an east-west normal fault. In
Okay.
the Bollman, area, in the Middle Atlas, the transgression is typically from the Tethys.
Okay. Okay, I see. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Understand?
Yeah, thank you.
I see that we have another question potentially in the chat. Ahmed, but if it is really short question, please.
Yeah, a very short one. Thank you so much. And thank you, Mustafa, for your presentation. As I have seen in the maps of paleogeography that this transgression of Upsian is kind of some gulfs. And I was wondering if there is already some relief, because it's not a generalized transgression. Is there already some relief in between the gulfs? Meaning that the tectonic inversion of the Atlas has already began pre Upsian or Barremian. Thank you.
What is the question?
The question is why the Upsian transgression is not uniform? I mean, it is kind of gulfs. Is there some paleo relief that inhibiting the transgression to be uniform?
Yes, the Upsian transgression is uniform. That's the central Atlantic in the lower Cretaceous have been an uplift. So you can see the publication of Frison de la Motte, an uplift. The paleo topography is uniform, and the extension in the Arbala Naur area, the transgression Upsian is preceded by a continental rifting.